Because our special guest is John Hovind, governor of North Dakota, who joins us. Can you hear us, John?
Good morning, Laura. How are you?
Are we turning up our IVs?
We are.
Can John hear us now?
Good morning, governor. I can hear you.
Good morning, governor.
Good morning. Good morning. Yes, I can hear you.
Hi. Now we can see, well, we have a nice full screen picture of you. That looks very nice. It looks like your headshot.
Well, that's great.
So you are here to talk to us about your Senate run. And I just wanted to ask you how things are going and where you stand with everything. I don't know if you've had a chance to listen in on what we've been talking about health care and terrorism, but why don't you tell the folks what's happening in your world?
Well, I am running for the Senate, and really I'm running for same reasons that I originally ran for governor, and that's to get a clear focus on job creation. We have to make job creation job number one and create an environment in which businesses can invest and hire people and get this economy going and growing again. And I think that's a big part of also getting on top of these other issues, like with good fiscal management, our national deficit and the debt and doing more on health care and the other things that are important to the citizens around this country as well.
And in your talking points, you say that we all need a plan that will create good jobs. What kind of plan are you proposing and moving forward?
Well, I think you've got to create business certainty from a legal, regulatory, and tax standpoint. You've got to lay down the rules of the road in a way that enables businesses to plan and to invest. To give you a specific example of what I'm talking about, in energy policy, instead of bringing a massive tax in the form of cap and trade that's going to affect every American family, every business, instead let's come up with a comprehensive energy plan that really empowers our industries, with all the different industry sectors within the energy industry, whether it's traditional or renewable, to move forward and make investments. That not only helps us provide the energy we need at a cost where we can compete in the world market, but it puts a lot of people to work.
Bob, you're a businessman. What
I am.
About that?
I actually have to say, Governor, that one of the interesting things to me is I was actually, I used to run a public company, a NASDAQ company, here in New York. And I remember very well being recruited by the state of North Dakota to come out there and move my business. You guys had a very compelling argument about low tax regime, low regulatory regime, and I had some very nice flashy materials, and it was quite a compelling argument. I couldn't convince my wife that North Dakota was a good idea, but from a business point of view, it looked like a good thing.
Now you should have come. Since then, we've cut property taxes, we've cut income taxes, and I think we have created a very strong business climate in our state.
Yeah, no, you have done a good job of that. But when you talk about the energy fixes that you would like to see, exactly what do you see, for example, with respect to things like natural gas, which is a huge resource that we have in the United States we're not using, and which clearly would cut down our dependence on foreign oil dramatically?
Well, it's an incredible opportunity. We're producing far more natural gas in our state, and we've done a number of things. In addition to tax incentives, we've also helped them build the infrastructure to get more product to market. So we're not only finding more natural gas in new formation, like in our case, it's in the Bakken formation, we produce a lot of oil, but we also produce natural gas with it. In other parts of the country, it's the Barnett Shale.
Right.
So we're tapping much more natural gas with new drilling technologies that are more environmentally friendly, produce more natural gas. But we also now, here in North Dakota, for example, are producing synthetic natural gas from coal. We're capturing the CO2 and we're putting it downhole for tertiary oil recovery. So again, it's about getting these industries to deploy these new technologies in new ways, produces more domestic energy with better environmental stewardship.
Governor, while I have you, I also want to ask you about your views on health care. Of course, it's a very important issue that we continue to keep the discussion moving here in the Strategy Room and on Fox News Channel. Tell us a little bit about your stance on that so we get a read on you.
Huge issue right now, no question about it. And this massive 2,700-page bill in Congress is not the way to go. I mean, it's $500 billion in tax increases, $500 billion in reductions to Medicare, and it doesn't help with the federal deficit. It exacerbates the federal deficit. We need to get to more of a market-based approach where we empower people to not only choose their own health insurance, but their own health care providers to work to make it more affordable and more available to people with things like tort reform, transparency in pricing, expanded health savings accounts, portability of insurance, more competition among insurance companies across state lines. Those are the kind of things that can really make a difference both in terms of affordability and getting more people covered.
Scott, you've been so vocal on that.
Yes, well, I do. I respectfully disagree with you, but I would want to say that I was talking to some people from the strategy room, and North Dakota is one of the most wholesome, nicest states in the country, just from your accent alone. And what I'd like to know is, how would you bring this North Dakota sensibility of civility to Washington, where there's no civility, just bitter partisanship? How would you bring that?
You know, I've been a governor now. I'm actually in my middle of my third term, and you know, you have to find ways to work together to get things done. And I'm not sure how you do that in Washington, D.C., but I'm certainly willing to roll up my sleeves and get started.
Governor, this is Adam Geller. I just want to compliment you for the way that you ran your state. The reason I say that is because I'm a pollster for Republican candidates, including Governor Chris Christie. And during the campaign last year, Governor, John Corzine, then governor of New Jersey, was quoted as saying that if people in New Jersey don't like his policies there in New Jersey, they can move to North Dakota. And so clearly he knew something, and I wanted to compliment you on doing something right, because that was John Corzine's prescription.
Mm. They certainly can, and we would welcome them with open arms. We have a lovely state, and we are creating more opportunities for them, and we'd love to have them.
Well, they decided to vote for Chris Christie and give him a shot, but it's always good to keep in mind.
I know Chris Christie. He's a great fella, and I wish him the best. He's got a huge challenge with that budget in New Jersey.
All right, Governor, thank you so much for joining us. That is North Dakota Governor John Hoeven running for U.S. Senate. Best of luck to you, and check back with us here in the Strategy Room when you get a chance.
Thank you.